little Spanish flu. Do it.
I would have suggested a bit of Frank Zappa, but maybe we could say that for another time.
Say that for a different time, yeah. The Muffin Man, preferably.
Yeah. I like how Jester is now playing Left 4 Dead 3 gazillion 133 trillion something.
Listen, where the fuck is my music, son? I hear dragon, I don't hear music.
I don't hear any either. That's probably because I don't have a stream window.
Preemptive strike against the team taking 40 minutes to get to the server, which will actually load my game.
5 seconds.
Ask myself why I have 40,000 PM windows open.
Well, now it's half 8, and now I should be started. I suppose Rep did take up your offer then. Okay, I guess.
With your bullshit lies. Dragon's the one in middle age.
Middle age? I'm just another one of those guys where people assume I'm like in their mid-30s or something, but I'm far younger.
Thank you, Sid, for your excellent work of... What program are you using for that shit? You can do that with XSplit? I can barely cast with this world, barely stream with the thing. It's upsetting though, you do not have the Earth for Dead logo on there. Please rectify this.
I remember I saw sending a link to one a while back, didn't I? Did that get to Jeff or SL?
It didn't, but I just PM'd it to Sud now because I'm lazy.
Alright.
I meant to give it to Zeon, but I haven't seen him online. So he can remake the, but he just changes the logo on the HUD.
I have got Drac asking me how which side to start first for survivors infected.
Start to check it down, PM. I sent you a link. Coin toss.
Yeah, I just said that to him. If only I had a coin next to me.
Well, I am. I don't have a coin, but I have a good few bottle tops, so we could probably do this. I must have a coin somewhere. Get out of my channel, we're casting. That worked.
So you have a bottle cap ready then to flip.
Hold on, let me clear some crap out of my desk so when I do flip it, you can actually hear it.
Okay. Oh, wait a minute, I'll call, ask what Drac wants to tell. Or top or bottom.
I actually found a pound coin in my pocket, so I got money. Let's do this shit.
Okay. Hold on. Okay, heads.
Oh, so they want heads, yeah?
Yeah.
Flipping coin in 3, 2, 1, flipping. It's heads.
Okay, yeah. BRB, starting as survivors first.
Johnny, do we even have a server yet?
Yes we do.
What kind of question is that, Sysmo? No, you are not allowed to spec in the server. Teams are currently getting in the server, so good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another competitive Left 4 Dead 2 cast. I am Battle, and by my side I am joined by the illustrious Light Barnabas Dragon. Say hello, sir.
Hello, everyone.
And you join us for the CGFB Cup. This is round one, essentially, of the group stage. This is Group C, I believe.
Group B.
This is Group B. Sorry, I'm on drugs. Nonetheless, Team Snipe, Team Be Right Back, and Team Ladyboys. Team Ladyboys will be setting up on Special Infected per the coin toss, and Team Be Right Back will be playing Survivors. Map today is Dead Center 1-3, and it will be played on the Equilibrium config, which is 1.1. I swear Jazzy said 1.2 would be coming today.
It did, didn't it?
Fear we have been lied to.
You better be careful. Might turn into the very next project, Sam.
Damn it, fix it. Nonetheless, once we get the servers, we shall give you the rundown of the opening SI attack, as I assume the match will be going live shortly, and I'm still loading. Mainly due to my illegal activities, which require me to obtain things I shouldn't be watching. Is also making me load into the server slower than Dragon, consequently. Aha! I'm here. Right, so here we go. For the survivors, we of course, Team Be Right Back, And their lineup is Blazing Drac, Maniac Fish and Jazzy, and take away Lady Boys Dragon.
For our Lady Boys, we have No Foes, Zed, Aizen, and Locke.
A couple of returning faces from the previous CGFB, in terms of, I don't think Maniac Fish or Blazing played, but I know Drac and Jazzy definitely did. They played for a team called Sex Damage.
Yeah. They're a bit unfortunate with Sex Damage, because they didn't have a bad team. They even drove Too Late pretty close in their qualifying groups, and of course Too Late went on to win the first CGFB Cup and are playing extremely solidly in the current Equilibrium Cup.
Too Late have definitely got a lot of experience under their belts now. I mean, they've progressed from the CGFB Cup extremely well. I think they're in for a very good shot to actually win the Equilibrium Cup. We do still have teams like Moby Dick and Vertigo Rise. If people don't know who they are possibly, well, definitely the top two American teams at the moment on the Equilibrium config. Teams are readying up slowly though. The opening attack for the SI is a Hunter, Smoker, Spitter and a Boomer. So a 2-2 setup, but not too essential on this, thanks to the fact that everyone wants a charge off that death charge. I'll take this time to mention a couple of changes of the Equilibrium config over Fresh. There is no SI slowdown, there is no tank slowdown. There are 4 sets of pills in the safe room, and there are 4 additional sets of pills floating around the map. The Scout has replaced the hunting rifle. The Scout does 160 damage per shot. The shotguns are at the moment a little bit higher than vanilla in terms of their damage, but they will be toned down in the next update, which should be coming soon. What else do we have? We also have tank blocking capabilities, so there will be no pre-elevator tank. The tank will always be forward on the bottom floor of this map. We also have custom distances and custom health bonuses implemented. And we already have a spectator.
Yeah. You know, we even have one from Lady Boys as well. Rice being speaking in Russian in the spec chat, as I can tell. So Rice is a sub, but yeah, like I was saying, it doesn't have to be in the server at the same time.
Ladies and gentlemen, we do have a stream, so please do not join the server, although momentarily you will not be able to join the server, as we are about to remove all of the spectators and limit the slots. Just message Jazzy, and he's already on it. Good man, good man. I think he's going to have problems kicking Ryze though, because Ryze has a really funky ass name.
Yeah. It's not a simple copy-paste job either.
The mind the round is going live. Opening attack once again is a 2-2 setup. Hunter, Smoker, Spitter and Boomer. Team Lady Boys on Special Infected. Team Be Right Back on Survivor. Take away the first attack dragon.
Will do. Okay, well, Vic is at the front there, opening the door, in the control of Drac, who's got double pistols. It looks as though the survivors are doing a 2-2 with two axes and two double pistols. Hunter's set up at the front. Spitter looks as though he's going to come from the right along with the smoker and the boomer. But Drac hurries along and closes the doors. And he can tell where that Hunter is. But doesn't land a single bullet. And Jazzy comes and swings the axe on the Hunter's head. And they're pretty much going to rush past this first attack. Spitzer is behind. But a quad boom even, a mouth bag going in. And with a smoker as well, there's still a smoker up. Maybe he could try a pull here. Smoker is positioned on the floor below. He may be able to get a pull.
Oh, he does get his pull. Oh, he doesn't go down.
On the edge. There's a jockey as well, we need to be careful. And Jazz, Oh, Mr. Smoker is still at half pull there, but there's a witch.
Dude, I think one thing they need to do now with the smoker as well is scratch out those doors, the bottom floor.
And the witch is already slightly troubled, although there's a smoker there now.
Well, they do have two melees and two sets of pistols. They could draw with a pistol and then try and melee her down, but the SI attack is up. It is another 2-2 setup. Spitter, smoker, boomer, and a hunter. The survivor's cautiously going for this witch. Smoker goes for a pull on Coach. He does get the pull, which has
bugged out. Oh, she's glitched out.
Oh dear.
Unfortunately, that... Well, yeah, it's unfortunate all the same.
Yeah, attack is going in, though. The hunt does land in spit, and there is a boomer that gets a quad boom again from a prop. Smoke goes down below, and a hunter rebound. Hunter has been cleared, but the smoke is still going on.
It's quite a hefty ton of damage there.
It's a great amount of damage, considering the witch bugged out, but due to her bugging out, she did manage to run through the survivors, stumbling them all into the spit.
Yeah,
it's excellent damage spread, and there is a charger up as well. They might go for a last-second death charge attempt here. Oh, they are going
it's
for
going.
It. Ooh,
too
he's
late.
Gonna miss it. Well, thud, elevator music, cue.
Yeah, I mean, that witch, even though she completely glitched out, I mean, that helped with a spit as well. Doubled the amount that she would have done to just one survivor anyway and split it across.
Definitely, I mean, it's an excellent damage spread for essentially a bugged out, annoying AI witch, which actually helped in a sense. I mean, why have one in-cap when you can have four survivors chipped across the board? And there is the tank. Tank is up in the hands of no foes, so let's take this over to an infected Warum.
Ready? Runs down.
Go in. What? Behind him.
Need help.
Help him. Go. Go in. Oh my god.
We are about hitting jet. There's an attack coming in. A hunter does land. The charger does fist down one survivor. Gets leveled by another. Tank has been killed, but again, excellent damage spread. Three survivors reduced to no solid HP whatsoever. The rest of the health bonus currently remaining on Ellis, who is currently being played by Blazing. Survivors have probably two more attacks to take prior to reaching safe room. They don't have much of a bonus, but they are making distance.
Yeah.
Of course, with the modified custom distances and health bonus for this map, it's only 300 points. A boom does proxy in on one survivor, though. That's Nick in the front. It looks like... it does look like a sack. There's a hunter spawned up, though, and a jockey in spawn mode with a spitter as support, so it looks like they're going to sack this boomer and hope for a charger.
Yeah. Oh, so the hunter got himself killed.
I think he got... Did he get himself killed or did he burn himself?
I don't know if he was already burning, but the last time I saw him, he pounced against a wall and ricocheted off it dead.
Oh dear, well, a delay spit does go out. There's just a jockey up in spawn mode, and their spawn timers are now exceptionally split. They have a smoker and a jockey up. A third spawn's coming up, which is probably going to be a boomer, and it is a boomer. Last spawn, though, is still 10 seconds out. Survivors did find a spare set of pills. They're going to have to be careful here how they take the
boomer and jockey behind. Stumbles a jockey. And a smoker. Oh, he tried going for Rochelle, but the pillar blocked his tongue. He needs to cover that, and they do so. But there's a charger up ahead.
Charger gets the fist in on Jazzy before getting out of there. I believe that will be Jazzy. No, that won't be Jazzy Black and White. That's his first down. But that's going to help the health bonus a little bit as they do push it. Blazing doing a great job of preserving his health bonus as well. So that is the first round. Team Beer at Bat making safe from with an 84 health bonus and a maximum 300 distance points, giving them a total score of 384. So let's see what Team Ladyboys can do here now on their survivor round.
Yep.
Which is a pretty shit place as well.
Yeah. There's another good thing I like about this campaign now is that the scoring system for this first map has been chopped down now to a more acceptable level, because 500 points and a potential 1,000 bonus to go with it on what would appear to be a very luck-oriented map. Especially in Fresh as well, it's a little lessened because of the tank being blocked off. But, I mean, 300 is an acceptable distance, I think.
The round is already going live, though. A recap again of the opening attack for the SI, which is Team Be Right Back on Special Infected and Team Ladyboys on Survivor. It's a 2-2 setup, Smoker, Boomer, Hunter, and a Spitter. Let's see what Be Right Back do with this. Hunter is currently scratching out the doors. The smoker wants to try a pull from the front. The hunter is pre-spawned in the room to the right of the survivor. Where is that boomer? Boomer is also in there, as is the spitter. So if we can get a nice pounce in spit, followed by a stumble in spit, that could be some massive damage off the first attack. Smoker does get a pull in front. Hunter gets a nice intercept. The boom goes out on three survivors, and a spit goes down on that. And there goes a stumble as well into more spit. Ooh. Ellis is caught with a lot of commons on him, and he's in spit.
No, smoke is
still going on.
Wow, that's two survivors down on slow.
Dude, that's a phenomenal amount of damage, and they will have at least two spawns up for this witch as well. Smoker did die very late compared to the rest of his SI, but they do have three spawns up. Jockey, Spitter, Hunter. Final spawn coming in is probably going to possibly a charger. It may even be a boomer though. It might be another 2-2. It is indeed a 2-2. Let's see if they get the same luck with that witch the other team got.
Hunter burnt himself.
That's pretty good actually. I mean,
yeah.
It forces the survivors to either take 15 points of damage as they run through that, or they choose to go around and risk the opportunity of another death charge for the SI.
Yeah, well, there's a possibility that this witch could also bug out, but knowing her luck, it can go anyway.
The boomer does spawn up below the survivors and does get a double boom.
He burns himself as well, does he?
Al-Qaeda boomer going up. Well, the jockey gets a ride and the spit goes down on that. Again, another good amount of chip going in. But, have to be really quick with this witch, they may suffer an in-cap. Looking for the draw on her. There is three melees. She's standing up, she is off. She does get an in-cap. Ooh, there's a charger up and Ellis is in a bad play. There comes a charge. Ooh. Doesn't get the death charge.
Blazing almost had it.
Smoke goes out in front though. Double boom going off on that. Tri-boom now thanks to that proxy. Ellis is very close to dying here, they got to pick him up quick.
And of course with their health, I mean it's too risky limping through fire.
Yeah, at this point though, they're taking so much damage, they have two sets of pills left which they're going to have to give to the two people who are slow. Oh, they do find an extra set of pills before descending down the elevator.
Jazzy has the charger as well, Drax got a jockey for support. This is all before the lower level where the tank's going to be.
Well, it's a very preemptive, there is a jockey going in from behind, a spitter up in front and a charge. Charger going in, gets his charge, gets leveled, but a spit goes down. Taking a little bit more
Lock
damage.
Goes down.
Yep, that's a very preemptive pill pop as well. Lock just popped a set of pills. I mean, what a lot of teams like to do here is obviously keep them pills for the elevator, because you're just going to bleed out more.
Perhaps tank is options here. I mean, even though they will have four signs of SMGs downstairs, the survivors can't exactly get great long-range chip.
It's a very annoying area to be a tank, because I mean, you know, you take one wrong foot and you're going to walk yourself right into fire and light yourself, which is going to make it easier for the survivors. But on the plus side, they do have a decent setup, so tank is just about to spawn, so let's take it over to an infected forum, so.
Bush Allen, coach.
Only one boom.
Just go tank.
Going.
Spawn up, just to confuse them. Let's go.
Only one up.
Sorry.
You got it.
You got it.
Nice.
Well played.
We are back, ladies and gentlemen. That was the opening tank of the game for Team B. Right back, managing to secure the wipe, giving Team Ladyboys an overall score of that map of 201 points exactly. So, going into map 2, Team B. Right back with a 183 point difference. Not an exceptional lead going into map 2, but points are still points. Map 2, arguably one of the most endurance-based maps in the Dead Center campaign.
I think that's pretty much the best map of this whole campaign, map 2, because, like you say, it's an endurance one. You know, the tanks have quite some potential to do a lot of damage if played wisely. And, you know, there's also that unique sort of cola event run at the end.
Yeah, there's one thing, though, I haven't really seen much of on this map in recent matches, and that is one of the earlier tank spawns. I tend to see a lot of the tanks spawn just before the survivors reach the gun room before the event. Be nice to see a nice early tank to play around with his car, see what can be done with them. Yeah. But opening attack for the SI is another 2-2 setup. Hunter, Smoker, Spitter and a Boomer. Exact same setup as the previous map. So Team Ladyboys on Special Infected, Team Beer Back on Survivor. See what they do with this opening hit. Not a great one, this is it does have good damage potential with the Hunter and the Spitter. Beginning to worry me, son.
I gotta say, I think I was most impressed by Blazing in that first map.
Because he did exceptionally well.
Yeah, he got a lot of infected kills when on Survivor, and he also carried the health bonus. Yeah.
Well, the tat looks like it is poised to come in. Of course, the Boomers looks like he wants to rocket in from this archway above the Survivor. Hunter has pre-spawned and he's jumping around, just trying to distract. Smoker's behind the trailer as well. It looks like the cap is going to be coming in from the ground, whereas the Spitters and Boomers come from the top. Here comes the Boomer. Boomer gets a double. Smoker does get a pull and the Spit goes down. They're looking for a rebound, but he's not going to get it. A little bit of damage.
They're all jazzy right for Despit.
Not bad at all. The points, very respectable for a 2-2 hit, which essentially got taken out really quickly. See about 14 points of damage going in from the Boom, 8 from the Smoke. And 38 from the Spit, thanks to Jazzy running through Desperate. Next SI attack is coming up, the Jockey, Boomer, Hunter, and the final spawn is a Smoker, so take it away, Dragon.
I'd probably say this is like the least ideal setup they could have for this interior section. I would have wanted to have a charging Spitter if it was my team, but Hunter is actually pouncing outside. He wants to go for a damage pounce from above the building. So it seems like the Infected will be planning for an attack once they come outside. I can see the Boomer is poised by the pickup truck outside. Smoker's going to try and come from the stairs inside. And a Jockey's going to be from above as well. It's got the Survivors on edge, always looking above themselves. Jockey comes in. Hunter bounces in, rapidly trying to wall pounce, getting his target, but gets him too, and then swung with a bat. And Smoker pulls Nick at the front, but briefly. Not a lot of damage on the board, but... Yeah, I think it was still well thought of by the infected team. It's not like they pulled up a bad attack.
Not at all. And besides, I have a question. Do you still have the Cuban Pete tank music? Hey, look out, watch out. Cuban Pete. I remember you used to have that. Reloading. Unfortunately, Ladybugs, though, Ladyboys, not paying attention to their, it's from the mask, you idiot. Not paying attention to their sacking rotation. And they do have yet again another 2-2 setup. Jockey, Boomer, Hunter and a Spitter. Ideally you want the charger for this choke point if you plan to hit on it. But they can still do work with the pounce and Spit.
Yeah, it's the second attack in a row, they haven't had a charger, but I mean they've got the Spitter this time, so it's just what this Hunter can do basically. I should go in, lands the Spit. There's a Boom on Jazzy. It's a run down the spares. Bit through the Spit, and then Jockey briefly goes on Drac.
Pretty good take though, I mean, not that much damage going out. He was out the Spit pretty comfortable, even though the spread was pretty huge.
Yeah.
A reminder to our viewers, if you are playing in the CGFB Cup and you're not fully aware of when we say sack rotations, basically whatever you kill first, you have a much higher chance of getting again in the next attack, and whatever you kill last, you won't get. So if you want a Boomer for the next attack and you have a Spitter as well with it, you just want to get rid of the Spitter last and keep the make the Boomer die first, so you'll have a Boomer in the next attack and three cappers instead of a Boomer, Spitter and two cappers.
I'm sure Cuban Pete was worth it if you were using him for your tank music, so. Does that not ring a bell? Anyway, Smoker's coming in from the back, tries pulling Nick at the front. Jazzy goes to try and rescue him. Jockey tries to pounce on Jazzy, but doesn't land. But the charger is at the bottom. I've kept Drac and Spit, and he goes down to it. Then cap on Drac, he will be bleeding out for the rest of the map.
Dude, no tank spawn as of yet either.
There it is.
Never mind, there he is. Tank is up in the hands of Aizen. Let's take this shit over to an infected war up, so.
Don't let them go up. Don't go in, let's give him an attack first.
Yeah,
the tank passes.
Pull someone.
Yeah, I'm ready. Ready?
Hold on. Ah, oh, fuck out of here.
Wait. Wait, dude. We need one more, and you can go in.
Ooh, I can spawn behind that tree.
Nice.
Yeah, I'm losing control. Just go with the Bimmer. Save the others. You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Go with Bimmer. As fast as you can.
Let him.
Too early. Way too early, Ice.
Kill him, Knuckles. Fight.
Climb up there.
Hide, nice. Nice.
I know a good spawn here, guys. Follow me.
Land that boomer, please.
Follow me. Oh, they got him up.
You should have punched him and killed him with the car, I think.
Two more health, half the one.
Yeah, just go. Land the... Why do you go so early?
Ison, come on.
It's gonna go AI. Start dancing. Fuck! AI.
Wow.
Back, ladies and gentlemen, a nice double charge going in there just as the tank was killed, but that was the tank fight. Managing to get a good separation punch on Jazzy and taking Coach down. Drac is bleeding out as well. There are no sets of pills left remaining on the survivors. They may have some to look forward to in the gun room. Survivors managed that tank relatively well. I mean, they still have good health bonus, but they do still have this whole event to take and no sets of pills currently on them. It's going to make it difficult.
Yeah, they've basically got to scrounge whatever they can find, because this event is pretty difficult.
This is a 2-2 setup as well, so they want to go inside the gun room.
Yeah, it would make sense to do that. I'm just coming in, pounces on Jazzy. It was not a health bonus. I think the spitter got killed before she could even spit. Been a while since I've heard Whittaker's voice in a cast, I must admit.
You see, sir, I call Cuban Peter tank music and the fucking stream loves it. The stream chat is filled with thanks for you and your Cuban Pete. We're good to go. I'm not a man
to weasel out on it. You see, there are some custom sounds and music types that are, you know, bring joy. And there are others that are clearly illegal. Cuban Pete is completely legal.
Definitely, they do in-cap Drac. So he is going to be black and white? Yeah, he is going to be black and white. Drac is black and white. Jazzy suffered one down. Boomer rockets in really early from above and gets a double boom in. There is a jockey and a spitter set up inside. Oh, and a charger now as well.
Inside.
Charger goes in, gets two fists in, but gets taken out. A spitter has been taken out as well, I do believe. Word out of both Lexan's book there.
Drac is walking on a tightrope, he's black and white and with 3 health remaining.
Oh, and there's a hunter up as well, might go for that crafty hunter scratch for the kill. They are making distance here. Blazing and Maniac Fish and great HP.
He almost got owned by that commander, Drac.
There's a smoker up behind, gets a separation pull in on Jazzy.
That hunter's cleared. Coming in.
Oh, here comes the hunter. Oh! Maniac's keeping the hunter and saving Drac's pitiful existence.
But Drac goes down to the spit.
There is Drac dead, one survivor dead, still 3 up. Jazzy's on very low HP though, just a boomer in front of the survivors to stop them putting this in. M2'd like a boss. Pop him!
Oh no!
Stumble takes one survivor off and the jockey gets the intercept. Charger desperately trying to find a spawn, so is the smoker. They do find their spawns. That could be the wipe right now. That is the wipe.
Yeah, they were having a chuckle themselves about that.
Yeah, the M2ing that boomer, shamelessly bullying the fat man, and as a result he pops on them and screws them over. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen, never M2 a boomer for too long. Pubby does get his revenge. He does get it eventually. It takes him a while, but as you can see, it can lead to some disastrous consequences.
Yep.
Nonetheless, Team Ladyboys on Survivor this time round. They currently trail by about Dragon Do the Mass.
670 points.
There you go, 670 points. Team Be Right Back on Special Infected. And the opening attack is a 2-2 setup. Smoke a boomer, hunter, and a spitter. See what they get with this. I mean, there was quite a lot of damage going out from Ladyboy's initial attack, so let's see if Be Right Back can match it or beat it.
Well, it'll be interesting to see what they do with this 2-2. I mean, Ladyboys did get a decent chicken on his first attack, as I recall. But we just need to see what Be Right Back can do with it.
Let's go kill some zombies. See what we do, see what we get. Survivors, of course, going to bait these common in outside the safe room.
You can see Jazzy's Hunter has already pre-spawned. Sorry, Maniac Fish's Hunter has already pre-spawned.
You got there at the end, I'm proud of you.
Yeah.
Jazzy forgetting to increase the spec slot. Sorry, decrease the spec slot. He's left it at 13, we only need 11.
I think it's because Bam joined, Bam being an admin of his service. So he's actually coming in.
Ooh, a nice separation smoke in the back. Spit is just a little bit long, unfortunately, though. There's some nice chip going in from that boom and a good amount of damage from that pull as well. Not as much as Ladyboy's managed, but it's still acceptable chip. And it's on three separate survivors, so not bad at all.
Reloading! Reloading! I'm a reload! In here. Reloading!
Well, anyway, this next attack is coming up. It will be a spitter, jockey, hunter, and boomer. Well, this time they have a spitter. I remember the other team did not have a spitter for this particular bit.
They didn't know they had a 2-2. No, they did have one. They had a 2-2 setup. There is a hunter coming in from below and a jockey from below as well. Hunter and jockey going for the same target. Hunter does get cleared. A little bit of spit damage going in. Quite a bit of damage going in on lock, actually, from that spitter. Ooh, and someone running through Despot as well. They are slowly but surely piling on the damage here. They're getting rid of their attacks soon enough as soon as they come up, so they're getting hits on all the choke points.
Yeah, I mean, it seems like Ladyboys at the moment, that the bulk of the damage that they get is from spitter damage and assist.
Indeed, spitters are extremely horrible, but this next attack could be a pretty damaging one. It is a tri-cap, boomer, charger, hunter, and a smoker, so some good separation with the charge and smoke, and of course some good high pounce potential damage here for the hunter. I'm reloading. Looks like the SI has set it to go just on this dumpster choke point here, which could be bad if they do try to rush it and one survivor gets separated by that smoke.
But I think it's better than waiting for inside because they don't have a spitter, so they might as well try some separation here. Reload. I would actually like to see Blazing try and do a damage pounce from that building he's got behind him, but it doesn't look like he's going to go that.
Survivors have committed to the dumpster choke point. Boom does go in and get a boom in on one. The SI attack is coming in though. Smoke goes off in the back but gets cleared instantly. There's a hunter jumping around, he gets M2. Charge is destroyed as well. Is the attack cleared? Really good take by Ladyboys. Committed to the choke point, got one boomed as a result. He's taking a little bit of damage but not much at all. But it will give them enough leeway to push into this next choke. Ooh, but there is another spitter up.
Yeah.
Wives aren't waiting though, they're going for it.
It's a smart thing to do. I mean, there's a jockey, but it's another 2-2 though, the worst of all 2-2s.
Oh indeed. By far the worst.
Jockey gets M2.
Here comes the sack. Boom does go off on one and a spit goes off as well. That's going to separate poor Coach in the back.
Yeah, they've trapped Coach, but they got the timing that they need to actually go.
Poor Coach. Picking a couple of scratches there off the fat man and his ugly girlfriend. Survivors do make it out the choke point. They found an extra 10 pills as well, so Locke has pilled up and picked up the spares. So they're going into the tank fight in a pretty respectable condition. Next SI attack is coming up, which may hit directly on tank trigger. There is a hunter, a jockey, and the last two spawns are coming in 1 and 3 seconds. Charger, so that's not bad, that's a tri-cap, and they do have a boom with it as well. They are going to opt to hit before the tank spawn.
Oh, Hunter's gonna try for a damage pass, but he doesn't realize there's an invisible wall at that point.
That Hunter's getting heavily chipped. He is on the billboard. You could rocket that boomer in right now, and then the survivors are looking.
Yeah.
Oh. That does miss his damage bounce. Charger gets a fist and a charge, though. Boom goes out on one. Double cap going on. Ooh, a nice separation jockey going on in front. Unfortunately, not close enough to look at the tank, but some good chip going in on Aizen. And a great deal of chip, removing all of Locke's remaining permanent HP as well. So that's definitely going to be one set of pills committed prior to tank fight. Next SI attack is coming up momentarily, though. They do have a smoker thus far in spawn mode. But the way the points are looking, it looks like it will be Blazing who will have the tank. And the tank is up. And he's been robbed. It's gone into the hands of Maniac Fish. So, Sud, I think there's between infected Warum with Cuban Pete, please.
I'll stay back here.
Okay, ready?
Ready.
Sack.
Be careful, dude, be careful.
Oh, you're passing there!
What is that? It's okay, we need to push it within our... Go in.
Nice!
Oh man, I've just spawned as a boomer as well. Oh,
what?
Fucking hell.
I think one of them crashed.
The screenshot.
Yeah.
What? That guy has one health, man.
Yeah, you got it. You got it.
Are you gonna land that boom?
Maybe. We'll see.
It's going live. It's going live. Go, Hunter!
You got this, Blazing! Oh no, you don't. You got this track.
Oh, she's going for the one pass.
He's delayed this pickup.
Well, we are back, ladies and gentlemen, and as you saw, that was B-Y-Back's tank. Incapacitating three survivors, the charger coming up and landing on the shell with a spit to follow up. She needs to get out of there. A jockey coming up, she might ca- Oh no!
Oh, the jockey misses his second lunge.
Leapfrogs over the wall.
He's back for second. No, he's gonna save himself.
He's gonna hazard it. Well, he goes again on Rochelle. All these booms just popping on the survivors. Gonna slow them down even more. They've only got one spare set of pills.
Told you the fat man would get his revenge. Suffering three down to that tank fight. I honestly thought that would wipe. Seemed the tank backed up way too much, so when that smoke was cleared, it resulted in the tank having to push in again and take a little bit more chip. The next SI attack is coming up. They do have a Hunter, Smoker, Spitter, and the final spawn's a Boomer, so it's another 2-2.
Hello, how are you?
Intel, get out with casting. Oh, damn it, Intel. Why I said use the casting channel, damn it!
Oh, well. One boom, but it's not going to work, of course, because hordes do not spawn during this moment of the map. I have a Spitter, Hunter, the Maniac getting his spawn now as a smoker. Blazing is just a couple seconds away from his spawn, which is a jockey, so 3-1 there. I also I think Blazing has been playing pretty well, actually. He actually had control of one of those tanks during that play.
There is a Hunter coming in, he gets M2'd and shut down though, the spit goes down on nothing as a result. And the jockey gets picked. But yeah, I think Blazin's had a really good match. Survivor's going for maximum distance here. Now I'm gonna walk behind this this truck. You guys are gonna miss me. To get the full distance of the event.
Yeah.
But they are gonna. Well, they are currently trailing by 171 points. Friendly banter going out between the teams. But the event has been triggered. The SI attack is up. It is a tri-cap with a boom. One survivor in there by himself, though. I'm not sure about that. There's, ooh, the jockey and charger are both spawned up. Charger missing his charge and stumbling the jockey as a result. Two survivors are now inside. There is a smoke going on outside, which incaps out. Boom goes out on coach, which incaps him. Charger's going to get his charge back, and the jockey has been destroyed. Charger gets two fists in and Rochelle and then gets cleared. Smoker going in for some scratches as well. Coach is very close to dying. Coach is dead. Now the horde's gonna turn on everyone they want to. Rochelle is on 1 HP.
I just thought they had a... Oh no, sorry, I was confusing the cola for a spare pills outside.
Got spare pills? Oh wait, that's the cola. They didn't even get the cola, they left it inside.
No, they haven't been able to go in yet, they've been slow.
Oh, Rochelle goes down to a common punch. There's a jockey up and a boom off in front. Jockey lands. I believe that is a black and white Ellis as well. Ellis has been killed. There's a charger coming in, that is going to be the wipe. Charger gets the final charge in on Locke and pounds him into the ground for the death. So it is a 171 point advantage to Team Be Right Back going into the final map, dead center of map 3.
Yeah, I mean, I actually think that Ladyboy should have incapped Coach and Ellis before they saw that event.
Definitely, I mean, horrible event, there's so many commons, it's so easy to get caught by SI attacks, either inside going for the cola or coming off the roof outside, so I mean, you want people with as much HP as they possibly can for that event, especially when they're going to be bleeding out anyway.
Yeah, absolutely. It's worth mentioning that this upcoming map, the Maw, is also a recipient of custom distance scoring and health bonus too. God, I hate Maw. You know, even I have doubts at times of whether it's right to make it a 400 distance map with 800 max bonus. But when you think about it, it is a very repetitive map. Plus the fact that it's not really a great map for tanks at all.
It's not a fun map at all by any means. I mean, I definitely think map 2 is the best of the dead center maps. But one thing that still baffles me about this is even with Equilibrium's removal of natural horde, this map still has them.
Yeah. It's quite unusual. I mean, that's obviously something Valve must have coded differently specifically for this map. But, I mean, I think that was always the unique aspect about this particular map was that there was always, like, mini hordes on a very regular basis.
It's insanely random, this campaign in general. Apart from this map, which is repetitive as hell, but, you know, natural hordes and shit. Opening attack, though, for the SI is a 3-1 setup. Charger, Spitter, Smoker, and a Jockey. 63% tank spawn. It's pre-event, at least.
That could possibly be in the corridor, where teams would have to prep the chair to be able to get over the broken door again. Well, quite a good setup here. Charger, Spitter, Smoker, and Jockey. They could do some great separation with that.
Ooh, we do have a charger going in, a double charge, and Spit going down on top of Smoke pulling Coach out of the Spit, though. But not that much damage off that first attack. With that instant charge Spit, there could have been a lot of damage potential.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, that was... that almost sounded like a double or even a tri-cap could have happened there, but great damage limitation on the part of Be Right Back. Todd points out there is 3 shotguns and 1 Uzi being run. And even though, I mean, there's quite a bit of a damage buff for the shotgun, I mean, one of the things I like about EQ is that with a slowdown removed, never mind that, Boomer's come in and got one. Smoker has grabbed on Ellis. Charge is a bit unsync with the rest of his team, tries to go for Rochelle, doesn't land. Drag gets pulled briefly. Tiny bit of Spit damage going on the board.
Still they need a consistent chip over like 3 different players though. That smoke going in right at the end there for a couple of scratches on 2 different survivors.
Yeah.
Seems that they're rushing a little bit too much. I'll be right back at the moment. They need to sort of slow down, pay attention to the spawn timers, because they're about to take another attack and they're still rushing balls to the wall.
Yeah, although it would help to rush this particular bit, because it's never nice having to deal with this escalator climb until you get to the top.
I don't know, since that's one of my gripes with rushing this map, not purely because, you know, that the possibility of the charge from the escalators is the fact that it's so easy to get caught in double caps. There is a boomer spawned up. He's waddling around above the survivors. Hank is moments away from spawning as well. There is a hunter pre-spawned and he's jumping around. Charger and jockey in ghost mode for support. A boomer's just looking for an angle so we can actually get a survivor at the moment, because he jumps in and he's getting popped.
Yeah.
This would be an excellent time with a natural horde coming in. Survivors have holed up in a pretty comfortable corner though to deal with most of the SI attacks. And here comes a hunter jumping in and the boomer follows in. Boomer does miss his boom, unfortunately. The hunter takes a little bit of chips, like one shot from a shotgun, and then jumps out. Over this door. Coming back in for a DP, but he gets skeeted by Blazing. Jockey does land, but gets cleared instantly. Just that charger left now. Survivors...
Ooh, there is a witch.
Where is she? She's in the pills room.
Interesting. I think that's pretty much the same area where the tank spawns, if I'm not mistaken. I mean, we're getting pretty close.
May spawn outside the glass and have to climb through the ventilation system to get in. Nonetheless, the survivors haven't actually moved the chair. Could be bad for them.
Could be very bad. I mean...
Ooh, a nice, sneaky little boomer spawn at the top there, getting a nice double boom. There's a spitter up and a smoker up, but it looks like they're going to be saving their attack for this witch.
Oh, they do have a chair in place, I've just seen.
One has moved it there.
So they are well prepared to run back. They are expecting this tank to spawn in any second. But that witch might complicate things. It would be horrific timing if they triggered this witch the same time a tank was triggered.
Don't think you can have a tank and a witch up at the same time. But the tank hasn't spawned already. The whole attack is set to go on this witch. They do have a charger, jockey, smoker and a spitter, so it's a massively damaging tricap. They do have plenty of... The problem is now though... Oh, they do rush in for the crown. What was that? Was that Blazing?
That was bravery by Jazzy there. He went in for the rush crown.
One cannot argue with... Excellent take on that witch. They do have one more set of pills in front of them. It looks like we are going to have an event tank. But as a result, they did keep the smoker in charge of wisely.
Yeah. I mean, once the horde's triggered, they can't really do much other than take it. Unless... Yeah, they could possibly run back. But they're going to have that horde filtering in, and the tank won't have to take it. There it is.
Tank is up in the hands of Zed, so let's take this over to an affected war room, Zed, because the survivors are going to run back.
They're going back.
I'll just kill it. Keep them back. Smoke. I will kill the charge. I'm gonna...
Nice.
Wait. Go now in. Go
yeah,
in.
Tank going.
Help me.
Oh, let's go.
Out, go. Nice.
We are back, ladies and gentlemen, that is a wipe. Team Ladyboys managed to secure that wipe just after the tank spawned, just before the first escalator of the event area. So that's going to stop Team B-Rat back in their tracks. They're only getting 225 distance points that map. They are still ahead, though, by about...
396 points.
396, just short of 400 points. So making Saferm on this map, with, you know, even with tiny health bonus, would give them the win. But they do still have that whole event to take, and a tank.
And a witch before that.
And I wish before that, of course, you know. But my expectations of this round for Beer Back especially is they're going to really have to split their spawns for that tank trigger at the event. They're either going to have to put two in the front and two in the back to stop the survivors rushing forward and also to stop them rushing back.
Yeah, well, Lady Boys can either choose to run back just like Be Right Back did, or they can choose to fight it on one of the sides of the of that floor where the event actually is. Because I've actually seen a few teams do that before, and although it's risky, no doubt, it could still work. I mean, it's survivable, but of course that was a long time ago. And on Fresh with Tank Slowdown. It could be a very different story.
Don't say Tank Slowdown. People like Champloo will get upset.
Yeah, you're right.
Because it's a skill.
Mm-hmm. My bad. I don't know why I said such terrible things.
Fucking think before you speak, Dragon. Think! Never mind, the opening SI attack is a 3-1 setup. Spitter, Jockey, Charger, and Smoker. And there's a lerp change going out. Drivers do have the scout as well. Oh no, they are going to drop it. Beams? Nope. They're keeping it. No. No, they are keeping it. Fuck you, Sud. Somebody wants my scout. Also, I was taking a sweet time. There's a natural horde about to come in 23 seconds.
Yeah, I mean, it needs to get a move on. It looks like that charger's waiting to come from the safe room. Which he does, so.
Smoker gets a pull in front, but he gets cleared. Jockey does land in the back. Charger does get a double charge. The spit goes down on that. A lot of damage from that spit.
Oh, 3 power. And does... no, it's already in yellow hell.
Scout didn't get charged. Survivors do make it past the first hit, though. Taking quite a bit of damage from it, but they are going to push forward. Next SI attack is coming up, but it is a 2-2. The worst 2-2 setup in history as well. Smoker, Spitter, Jockey, and Boomer. Weapons over here.
Reloading. I'd be surprised if they chose to attack here. Well, Blazing missed a spawn anyway. I'm reloading. But, I mean, they need to get rid of it right now. I mean, they might as well do it seeing as a bit of a horde trickling in. Now that's interesting. Have you noticed on the spec cutout that... Oh, well, never mind. Attack's coming in. Smoker is pulled briefly, but not for too long. Spitter got nowhere. Boomer got nobody. I'm presuming the jockey got killed. But notice the mob timer on the spec card. It's gone right back.
Yeah, it happened as soon as the survivor stepped out of the super.
Oh,
I need to be paying attention to this shit.
Well, it's last time I looked at it, it was going by the 82nd timers.
Watch like a hawk. Next SI attack is up, however, it is another 3-1 setup, and it is a relatively good setup for this area as well. Jockey, Hunter, and that Charger as well. Good damage pounce potential here, and some good separation with the Charger and the Jockey. Survivors are cautiously taking this choke point, not rushing into anything. They do have to take their time a little bit, because Nofos is bleeding. Here comes the attack though, Hunter has pre-spawned. Hunter gets M2'd and shut down. Charger did get his spawn, but he's quite a distance away. He gets shut down. Jockey does land though on Nofos, which is going to reduce him to slow, and he's going for quite a lot of damage.
He has indeed, yeah.
Might see a rush for this Witch Crown though.
Would be the wisest thing to do, although Maniac Fish is already a second away from his spawn. Reloading. Which is a smoker. Machete here. But I mean, you see, this is a tricky thing. I mean, there's nothing to say that Ladyboys won't push forward.
Exactly, that's why they have to really split their spawns, or at least land an early boom. So the survivors really have to reconsider what they plan to do. I mean, you can run back, yes, but like the horde is still going to come in. Yeah, you don't want a scout in this area, not with this horde about to come in.
Yeah. I think people confuse the scout too much for the HR in the sense that it's always got to be taken. I mean, like I've always said, and others have stated, it's a weapon of choice. You know, you can either choose to take it if it suits your playing style or if it suits you for a strategical need. But it's not like the HR where you can just take it 24/7 just because of its power.
There's an attack going in from behind though, Charger getting a couple of fists in. And a Hunter almost getting a pounce, but mostly getting M2'd and shut down. Nofo is reduced to near enough nothing on the health department. He's gonna go in and, I guess, take the hit from this Witch. Oh, he does get incapped by that Witch.
Depends on what setup they got now. They have a Boomer and a Spitter, and a Jockey. I mean, that's not an ideal setup for the Invader to have at all with this event about to start.
Oh, in the other sense as well, the survivors need to make the safe room to win.
With this, there is a charge.
It's a lose-lose with this tank spawn. It does spawn relatively early during the event, so they can rush back, but... Oh, the tank is spawned pre-event.
Wow.
Tank is up in the hands of Maniac Fish. Let's take this over to an infected Warum.
That's just bullshit.
Yeah, total.
Oh my god.
Push in, push in, tank, you were getting the wrong way.
Mm-hmm.
I can't even see the tank. There we go. We're gonna have to go. Help him up. Just him. Charges, clear. It's okay. It's one, just one. Perfect. Go cover kill it. Me. Yeah, cover, cover. Nice, guys, it's nice.
Yes. And we are back, ladies and gentlemen. That was another tri-cap landing for the SI, resulting in a wipe in the same place. Team Be Right Back taking the win on Dark Carnival on Dead Center 1-3, 1,096 points to 920. So an exceptionally close game. Lucky for Ladyboys, they thought they had an excellent chance there when the tank spawned pre-event triggered. Unfortunately, it was not to be. Tank committed, got Rochelle instantly, got her down. Nice double charge going off, giving the tank another free down. When the charger was cleared, the smoker and Hunter were able to capitalize on the still mobile survivors, and the tank just used his body to cover.
Yeah, I mean, it was a very good game. I mean, I was particularly impressed by a consistent performance, definitely Blazing. I'd say he's
have a very good game.
Yeah, I'd say he was my man of the match. But there were also great moments from Jazzy. I mean, Drak played a pretty good tag there as well with brilliant SI support. So it was a good game for them, definitely.
One cannot argue with it at all. I mean, definitely a close game. Both teams played exceptionally well. I do think, though, the scores do not reflect, I guess, a particularly one-sided performance from Be Right Back to an extent. But, I mean, most teams... It came down to map one at the end of the day. I mean, most teams getting wiped in near enough the same situations.
Yeah.
But nonetheless, it was a good game, and it was the second casted game of the CGFB Cup, so... Please stay tuned to Jeff's Steam group for more notifications of when these casts will go live. Thanks obviously to Sud for cameramanning, and SL helps out as well, as does Jeff when he decides to show his ass online. But obviously as well, thanks to Dragon for co-casting with me.
No problem.
It has been fun as always. Now we must retire to find PCWs. So good games and good night.
Good night, everyone.
You, Tobitha, I'm here with best friend Tabitha, who has a message for all the dum-dums out there.
It has come to my attention that some of you dum-dums took me a little too seriously in the past when I warned you about the battle cattle. While battle cattle are indeed a dangerous foe, they are one that should be fought ferociously. Recently, I've heard about several incidents where some of you have been running away from a fight where battle cattle were involved. This is not acceptable!
Tobitha, beware the battle cattle, but don't fear the battle cattle more often.